Hey folks, welcome back to another video. Join me on a grey day here in North Wales, complete with roadworks noise. Apologies for that. Boys over there panting away. Hot weather for black dogs. He feels the heat a bit, but he's always happy. Today's video is shortish. Well, I know I often say that, but I think this one will be shortish. Do you need a lanyard for cleaning sport routes? Of course the answer is no, but should you have them? Well, then the answer might be different. We never used to have lanyards, they weren't invented. So what we often did was just clip in with a quick draw. I will often clip in with a quick draw to this day, even though I had probably my biggest near miss with something very similar to this. When I get to the top of a sport route to clean it, I can just clip in and I wait it, job's a good one. It's really key that you keep waiting it, right? I'm not gonna go through the cleaning bit, it's just the lanyard chat, how to attach yourself so I'd be roped and other stuff, wouldn't I? But the incident I had was actually, I've done a video about it, but it was clip sticking basically. So something exactly the same as this. But what I did was, it'd be a struggle to replicate it. I clipped in, but what have I just put in there? I've put a twist into that quick draw. As you're weighting it, not a problem. But if you unweight it for any reason, it's really easy for that quick draw to end up spinning back round, taking the twist out, and you'll no longer clip to it. So I've said that I still do that, and I do. I'm just really, really, really careful with it. I always make sure there is no twist. Does it work? Yes. Is it safe? Yes. Could it be safer? Yes. So that's one option. It's kind of the worst option, but it does work, right? Lanyards, like I said, hadn't been invented. So what we used to do was get a sling, normally a 120, larks for that into belay loop or both loops, depends on your preference and also the manufacturer's guidelines. We would normally do a knot in it because that would give us a bit of flexibility. So I can clip in with that. I could shorten it and clip into that bit. It depends upon the lengths and stuff. Clip into that, do it up, stay waiting on it. A quick draw, I've told you why you need to wait that in case it twists or anything. Also, it is a static thing. There's not really any stretch in it. There's no stretch in this either. So if I climbed up and fell off, it puts a lot of shock onto all this. My body, the human body, is not great at taking big shock loads. So I need to stay snug on it. So I'd literally be dangling on it. It works, right? It does work and it still works to this day. But like I say, I guess its biggest disadvantage is the fact that it is a static thing, right? It's also, whilst they've done that knot, it is a bit adjustable. It's not like fully adjustable quickly. This is where lanyards come in. So I've got two on me here. This is the one you'll see like everywhere. I think there's some kids kayaking down there. This is a Petzl one, a connect adjust. It larks fits into there. It does say in the guidelines to do it there rather than through both. I have a self locker on the end, okay? This thing, I can get to my lower off, clip it in, it's already done up, so don't forget. And then I just pull that, so it's like within that range, infinitely adjustable, so I can be really tight on it very easily. It is dynamic. Don't kid yourself though, it's not that dynamic, it's not like a bungee cord. If you fall off on it and get a factor two fall or so, it's still putting a lot of force through this and your body, so I am not keen on doing that in the slightest. But it's easier to be tight on it. They're really quick to adjust just because of the setup here. They've got like nice ergonomic bits for your thumb and finger to pull it one way. And then when you're clipping, you just put it the other, super smooth and it just locks up. Great bits of kit. I'll have to double check the price, but I think there's something around £35-ish here in the UK, which they last a long time. It's not like it's shed loads, is it? But you know, it's more expensive than that sling you might already have or that quick draw you might already have. Really good though. There's other brands available. Camp do one, loads of other people. This thing, a Kong slide. The Kong slide is that orangey, bronzy metal bit, right? I think it was originally invented for Viaferrata stuff. And you buy it for about £4. I'll put a link to all these things in the description below, but these are about £4, so they're a bit of a bargain. And you have to supply your own rope. And they suggest 9mm, I'm pretty sure. Read the instructions. I think this knot's in slightly the wrong place here, and someone's done it. I'm right-handed, but I tie my figure of eights left-handed. So it confuses me a little bit when they're the wrong way and I want to do a nice neat knot, so I shall do it properly. There we go. Just thread that in. So you tie it around both loops of your harness. I've got this set up for the right length without a stopper, right? So I make sure that tail is hand-sized. I don't want it massive, hand-sized. I could do a different finish on it, but I don't do a stopper. And then I've got loads of this to play with. I can put a carabiner in. Again, a self-locker would be ideal. It's adjustable. Pull on it. So it's the same as a Petzl Connect. The place, it's not the same as a Petzl Connect. It's nowhere near as smooth to do it. And it's a bit harder to pull it the other way. Sometimes it's almost easier to pull the rope through and do that. So it's an adjustable thing. You can put skinnier rope on it. And I found it does lock, but then I'll be working outside the manufacturer's guidelines. So it says 9, I'm 99% sure. So do whatever it says on that. It has got this stopper, this little barrel knot in the end. So even if it did slip right through, can't come off the end there. But that's a real cheap option, isn't it? You could not even use that. Just have a length of rope attached to you, but then you're back to the sling issue that's not super adjustable to the fine tuning point that this and the Connect are. This is stretchy rope again, dynamic rope, but again, not that dynamic, is it? So you've still got to be really careful at staying snug on stuff. So do you need a lanyard for stripping a sport route? No, you don't need one. Is there a good reason not to have one? Not especially. Do I always climb with one? No, when I'm red pointing and stuff, I just like to have as little stuff on my harness as possible. And that might sound really silly, but you know, it's little tiny marginal gains, whether that's more likely in the head, isn't it? I'm not going to gain anything from the weight of not having that dangling off me. But in my head, if it gets me an extra point, something of a percentage, it's all worthwhile, isn't it? But if I am using that quick draw, like I say, I am super thorough and super careful with it because I'm aware it's definitely got some limitations, and a lanyard is just a much, much, much better idea. So there you go. Hopefully a shortish one. I think it was. But chuck those questions in the comments below. As always, happy to answer as best I can. You know the score with that because I say it every time. Other things I say every time are massive thanks for the support. You can keep supporting the channel by clicking the like button, smashing the subscribe button, find us on Insta, Facebook, use the Buy Me A Coffee link. All the support, massively appreciated. As I also always say though, massive thanks for watching. More videos coming up very soon.